Hey everyone, welcome back. I'm James Murphy and this is M Coding, where we try to get just a little bit better at programming every episode so that during the inevitable robot uprising, we will be spared. If you're watching this video, you probably already know what a for loop is and how to use it. This loop, of course, prints 1, 2, 3. But did you know that in Python, like many other languages, a for loop is actually redundant? What I mean by that is that you can rewrite literally any for loop using other things in the language, in particular using a while. For readability and performance, I wouldn't really recommend doing this in Python. However, understanding iteration is the key to mastering any programming language. So let's get to it. Let's replace this for loop that just prints out 1, 2, 3 with its corresponding equivalent using a while loop. The first thing Python does is to get an iterator for the object that you're iterating over. Then, morally, it's just a while true, and every iteration of the loop, we get the next item out of the iterator, and then run the body of the loop, which in this case is print. But there's the obvious error with this approach, which is, this is just a while true, it's an infinite loop, how's it supposed to end? The design decision that Python chose is to have an iterator's next call raise an exception in order to specify that the iterator is done. Running the code as is, specifically, we see that it raises a stop iteration exception. If this feels weird to you, don't worry, you're in good company. This is pretty weird. By their nature, exceptions are kind of supposed to be exceptional. But in Python, you get an exception with every single for loop, and that's just the way it is. That's the normal way to end a for loop, is to have this next call raise a stop iteration. For our next iteration, pun intended of course, we'll just try to catch that stop iteration, and then break out of the while loop once we receive it. This version actually works, we get 1, 2, 3, and then the process ends normally with no errors. But there's still a small bug with this implementation. Comment down below if you can see what it is, I'll give you a few seconds. Okay, if you're ready, here's what I mean. What happens if something besides the iterator, something in the body of the for loop, raises that same stop iteration? Python doesn't consider that a normal way to terminate the for loop, and we see the exception bubble up. But in our implementation, if we raise a stop iteration here, then we see nothing because we're specifically catching stop iterations inside of our try-except. So the issue here is that our try-except should only be around this next call, not around the entire body of the loop. The proper way to do this is with a try except else. This runs the code in the try block. If a stop iteration was raised in the try part of the try block, then it gets caught here. Any other exception bubbles up, and if no exception is raised, then the else block runs. You can kind of read this in your head as like, if exception, else do stuff. Now a stop iteration from the body of the loop will bubble up. We can of course check this by running it. And in the normal case where we're just printing, we see our expected 1, 2, 3. Take a moment and just pause to let this kind of sink in. Every single time that you use a for loop, all of this stuff is happening. And that's the reason that we have a for loop in the first place. Although it's technically possible to replace any for loop with its equivalent while loop, that would be a huge hassle and it's very error prone. So it's just better to have a keyword that expresses that intent more succinctly. The only other thing I wanted to point out about this for loop structure is that in this code, you can see we have this variable it, which is the iterator. Even when you're using the built-in for, this iterator is there somewhere. In our translation using the while loop, we could theoretically access the iterator inside the body of the loop. But that would not be possible using a normal for loop. However, if you wanted to make the iterator accessible in the body of the for loop, you could still do that like this. Just manually grab the iterator and pass it to the for loop. This works because iterators are themselves iterable, which is something I'll talk about in one of my future videos. That's all. Thanks for watching. Thank you to my patrons and donors for supporting me. And don't forget to slap that like button an odd number of times. See you next time.